Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you some things you may not know that you can do in the Maps app on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the Maps app has been around on the Mac for a while now, and it's accumulated a lot of cool, interesting features. First, here are some things you probably know that you can do, but not everybody does. You can switch views. You've got the regular map view that looks like this, but you can click here and then switch to transit lines, which will show you transit lines instead of the highways. What you get, of course, depends on your location. So here in Denver, we see all the light rail lines. In other cities, you may see subways, bus lines, things like that. You also have satellite view. And this will give you satellite imagery instead of just all the streets. And if you zoom in using the plus button here at the bottom right, the satellite view is pretty detailed. Now on top of all of that, you can switch to 3D view here. Click that and everything goes into 3D. Now let's go back to the default view and you can see buildings here are represented by little 3D models. You'll find this more commonly in big cities, but it's slowly spreading to just about everywhere. It's particularly good in downtown areas like this. Now you can rotate using the little compass control here at the bottom. Just click it and drag up or down to rotate around. And if you switch to satellite view, it's going to use a satellite imagery on top of the 3D models. So now you get this real 3D image of a downtown area. And you can zoom in pretty far. It's really great for getting to know an area before you go to visit it. You can also use this control here on the right to adjust the angle of the 3D view. Now to zoom in and zoom out on any view, you can use the plus and minus buttons here. But you also can go here to the scale and click and drag right or left. So this allows you to kind of scroll to change the scale. Now if you want to find a location, you can click on the sidebar button here and you can search for the location. But you could also use longitude and latitude if you like. So for instance, you can search for a longitude and latitude like this, and it'll take you to a particular spot and show you what's there. You can use two numbers separated by a comma, but you can also use other formats as well. So for instance, looking up on Google the longitude and latitude for a landmark, I can copy that. And if I were to paste that in, formatted just like that, it will find that location. So here we've got Stonehenge. And yes, Stonehenge is actually there in 3D, either with models or using satellite imagery. Also note that anytime you're looking at place information, you should also see longitude and latitude there so you can get those values as well as use them in a search. You can't copy and paste from here, but you can go and copy a location. And if you paste that location, if you notice, you'll get the longitude and latitude in the URL. Now the app itself actually has some features a lot of people don't use. One is to use multiple windows. So I can create a new window and have a second, third, fourth maps window open all at the same time. But I could also use tabs. So I could have multiple maps in multiple tabs, which really helps trip planning and things like that. When you're looking at street names, sometimes they can appear a bit too small. So you can go to Maps Preferences and there's an option for larger labels which will increase the size of the street names. Also notice the control here for always use light map appearance. We see light map appearance now because I'm in light mode. But if I go into System Preferences and then switch to dark mode, you can see Maps looks pretty good in dark mode as well. Now you may have also noticed in Preferences here there's weather conditions and air quality. So if you have those both turned on, you'll see weather and air quality at the bottom left. A cool thing about that is it'll change automatically as you move. So here I am down in the city, but if I move up into the mountains, you could see the temperature dropping, the air quality improving. And you can click on either the weather or air quality, and it will take you to a website that will give you detailed information like the forecast. And here's for air quality. Note that you won't see weather and air quality if you zoom too far out because eventually you've got too large of an area and it can't give you a temperature for this entire range. And there may be places where there simply isn't temperature or air quality reported. Now if you want to save a copy of the map you're looking at in a standard format, you don't have to screenshot it or anything like that. You can actually go to File, Print, and then instead of printing, you can use the PDF button here to save as a PDF directly or open up in Preview. And then when in Preview, you can use the markup tools here and be able to draw things, add arrows and things like that to the PDF. To get directions, click this button here and then you can type a from location and a to location. Or you could start off with a location by clicking here and then you can click directions. You can see it includes that place there. You just need to fill in the other one and it will give you various directions and you can click to select the route that you want. You could also switch between driving directions, walking directions, public transit directions, or biking directions. And biking directions, just like transit, are only going to be available in some locations. There are options for each one of these. So for instance, for driving, you can select avoid tolls, avoid highways. For public transportation, you can select what types of transportation you're willing to take. And you also have defaults for these in preferences under Route Planner. When you have a route plan like that and you go to File, Print, it will actually print out the different steps of that route. So you can see the printout or PDF that you might export is going to look something like this with a little map for each step of the way. A fairly new addition to maps on the Mac is Look Around. If you click and hold to select a spot on a street, usually in one of the major cities, you could see Look Around here. There's also a button in the upper right hand corner there. Click Look Around and it will give you this great view that you can use the mouse to click and drag and look around a 360 degree view of that location. You could also use the trackpad with two fingers to zoom in and out on the image. The images are pretty high quality. And you can use this to take a drive. So if you see the road ahead of you, just double click on a spot on the road and you move forward. So you can basically drive a route virtually before doing it in real life. There's also a picture-in-picture mode for Look Around. Click here and now Look Around is in a little box here. And now you could see the binoculars showing you where you are, and as you move around it'll show you there. You could also click and drag to move the binoculars to another spot. But what about the information that's on the map? If you find a location you can click on it and you'll get all sorts of information about it. If you find some information is wrong, you can scroll to the bottom and there's Report an Issue. Click that and it allows you to adjust the location and send information about what could be wrong and submit that to Apple. And presumably somebody reviews that and implements a change if it makes sense. You can also add a missing place. If you click and hold at a spot, it'll add a marked location. At the bottom, you can click and add a missing place and make your suggestion. So as you can see, over the years, the Maps app on the Mac has become a very feature-filled and capable application. There's still some ways to go though. For instance, I'd love it in the future if you could have a way to have a route with multiple stops. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.